It's holy time, so let's go. V I B G Y O R dab 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 and we're done. Hi everyone, it's Smita and today I'm going to be creating something fun and colorful and simple, quick and easy and wearable for Holi. And to all my non-Indian friends, Holi is the festival of colors, so we'll be incorporating all the colors of the rainbow and we'll be using our favorite dabbing method to blend, so it's so quick and easy. So if you're ready, let's begin. The first step is to use a primer, so I'm going to be using the P. Louise base and this is in the shade 2. You can use any eyeshadow primer that you have. If you don't, then you can also use a concealer. I'm using some translucent powder underneath my eyes in case there's going to be fallouts because I already have my foundation on. Today I'm going to be using the Fade Into Hue palette. This is from ColourPop and I'm going in this order. Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. For maximum pigment payoff, I'm going to be using a sponge tip brush which I received in a certain palette. And if you want to learn more about using this brush and the dabbing method, I'm going to link it right on top as well as in the description box below. Starting with the very inner corner, I'm going to simply start placing the eyeshadows by dragging it downwards using the sponge tip brush, one after the other. As you can see, this is so apt for Holi. It looks beautiful. Of course, we'll soften this up by blending it out. For the dabbing method, you need a firm brush to dab. There shouldn't be much wiggling room. I'm going to begin with this Folklore blending brush. Although it's a blending brush, it's pretty firm. Let's compare it to a regular blending brush. You can see the difference. The regular brush has more fluffier hair, longer hair, so there's more wiggle room. But with this, it's firmer. I'm going to start dabbing on the eyeshadows, two eyeshadows at a time. Super simple, you don't have to be precise, you don't have to worry about any blending, the brush is going to take care of that for you. All you have to do is dab gently. And once you're happy with the blending, move on to the next two eyeshadows. And you don't have to worry about cleaning the brush or anything like that, you just have to keep on dabbing. And in fact, I like a little bit of residue of the previous two colors left in the brush that combines with the next two eyeshadows and gives you that seamless blend. And this is how it looks. It's done a pretty good job. But now we'll take a bigger dabbing brush to go over this for that seamless, flawless blend. And this one's from Milani. I'm going to link a couple of my favorites in the description box below, so do check that out. This is a clean brush. All I'm going to do is dab all over my lid so all the colors combine. While they combine, you can also see the colors individually, but you get that seamless blend and the brush will absorb some of that excess product, giving you a softer look. I'm going to be using this shade called Love Warhol as my transition shade using the sponge top brush to carve out my outer corner as well as the outer crease. And then I'm using the large dabbing brush and I'm going to dab this till there's that seamless blend. That was such a quick blend and we are done with the lids, so I'm going to be dusting off that excess powder and then I'm going to be using Love Warhol in my lower lash line as well using the sponge brush. Using this Too Faced highlighter, I'm going to highlight my brow bones as well as inner corners. And to tightline, I'm using this waterproof black eye pencil by Makeup Forever. To finish up, I'm curling my lashes and using a coat of mascara. And the mascara that I'm using is the highly rated mascara by Milani. And here is the completed eye look. How easy and quick was that to create? And look at that blend. You can never go wrong with the dabbing method. I'm going to pair this look with a Revlon lipstick in the shade 13, which is hot chocolate. Using a tissue paper, I'm going to blot some of that excess lipstick, and I'm going to also use some translucent powder to mattify it, and that'll also make it long lasting. And here's the completed look. I hope you enjoyed this look and this video. Let me know in the comment section below. And if you did, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing if you're new here. I post several videos a week. And for your information, I've listed all the products that I used in the description box right below this video. And you'll also find links to my social media there. So in case you plan to recreate this look, don't forget to tag me. I love you guys so much. Happy Holi in advance. And I'll see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.